Dear viewers and friends, welcome back to KNS biochemistry channel. Namaskar. So in this video session, we are going to talk about one of the area of nanobiotechnology, that is self-assembled monolayers, SAMs. We will start the session now. So in this session under nanobiotechnology, we are going to see about self-assembled monolayers, abbreviated as SAMs, self-assembled monolayers. Here you can see that one example of the self-assembled monolayer. You see that nanoparticles, this is a gold AU nanoparticle, and these gold nanoparticles are attached on a surface and they are assembled in a row. These gold nanoparticles, they are assembling in a row and it forms monolayers. It's like this, one by one monolayers. So what are these SAMs, that is self-assembled monolayers? So if you see the definition of this SAMs, SAMs are nothing but organic assemblies that are formed spontaneously by the adsorption of molecular constituents from solution or sometimes from a gas, from a gaseous phase, onto a substrate with a specific affinity of its head group. So these SAMs are simply organic materials. They are going to assemble spontaneously, that is automatically they will assemble, that is with the help of some molecular constituents. They are present in the solution, that is liquid solution, or they are present in a gaseous mixture. And the head group of those molecular constituents, they will have affinity towards this organic constituent and they will bind, and it forms self-assembled monolayers. So interactions between the substrate and the adsorbate. So adsorbate is going to act as a that is a solid ligand. On that solid ligand, the substrate is going to be attached. So what kind of interactions are possible between these two, substrate and adsorbate? First interaction is physiosorption. It is nothing but the enthalpies of interactions are rather very, very low. The interaction, during interaction, see that the enthalpy will be low. That is enthalpy delta H will be less than 10 kilocalories per mole. That is typically from van der Waals forces only. So this kind of interaction is van der Waals interaction. So because of that, you see that enthalpy is less than 10 kilocalories per mole. This is one kind of interaction. Then another type of interaction between the substrate and adsorbate is chemisorption, the formation of bond, chemical bond, that is covalent bonds. These covalent bonds, they are more stable than the previous, the first one, the physiosorbed counterparts, where van der Waals force is applied. It is a very weak bond, but here this is a covalent bond, so it is a stronger one. The enthalpy for this covalent bond is, that is delta H, is greater than 10 kilocalories per mole. So first one is less than 10, it is greater than 10, so it is having more stability. Other forms of bonding which happens between substrate and adsorbate is hydrogen bonding, hydrogen interaction, the donor acceptor binding, and ion binding, that ion pairing, ion. You can see one self-assembled monolayer which is formed. So here you see that we have a organic interface, this green color head regions, their organic interface. These organic interface, they are going to determine surface properties of this monolayer. It presents chemical functional groups. So these are all the chemical functional groups. Then here you have the terminal functional group. This is the terminal functional group area. And the middle part, this part is a spacer, an alkane chain that is going to be used as a spacer here. And this spacer region is having organic nature. There is under organic interface. This organic interface, it is going to occupy 1 to 3 nanometer space. It provides well defined thickness to this monolayer, and this organic phase acts as a physical barrier, and at the same time it alters electronic conductivity and local optical properties. And this portion that is between the blue, the yellow color, that is a ligand or a head group or a ligand that is attached with this spacer. And the last one is this layer. It is metal substrate. This is the substrate, metal substrate. With this only organic matter is attached, and you are going to get monolayers. So here this portion, that is metal sulfur interface, this area, metal sulfur interface area. And the role of this metal sulfur interface is, it is going to stabilize surface atoms. It stabilizes surface atoms, modifies electronic states. So that is the role of this area. Spacer area is having its own organic interface area, and the organic interface area here, the first row is functional group area. It will have chemical functional groups. So this is a typical self-assembled monolayer. SAM. Then coming to this history and the models of SAMs. How are these SAMs are formed, and what is the historical development behind that? So in 1980, first SAMs, that is self-assembled monolayers of the type alkyl trichlorosilane, was developed on glass material. Glass is acting as a substrate. So in 1980s only, first SAM were produced. It is made up of alkyl trichlorosilane. In order to form a complete monolayer, these silane groups, they are going to condense with surface hydroxyl groups, that is OH groups, to form a thin layer of polysiloxane. So silane is going to interact with the OH group, and polymerization happens, you will get polysiloxane, and they will form a monolayer like this. This is one layer, monolayer. And this beads are hydrogen atoms. The black color one are carbon atoms. And this brown color at the center dot is silicon, Si. And the bigger one is oxygen atom. So monolayers are formed. Then after 1983, another type of SAMs were developed. These SAMs are made up of dialkyl disulfides developed on gold particles, AU. The assembly of these type of SAMs is held together by the bonds between the sulfur head groups and the gold surface. Gold surface is the substrate. Sulfur head groups are the functional groups. So the bonding, chemical bonding happens between the sulfur head groups and the gold surface, as well as van der Waals interactions takes place. Van der Waals interaction, very weak interaction. That van der Waals interactions takes place between neighboring hydrocarbon chains and the monolayers are formed. You will get a monolayer like this. Here in this case, silicon dioxide is acting as a substrate, on that substrate monolayers are developed. Here you can see that gold monolayers, self-assembled monolayers. Gold is acting as a substrate here and the monolayers are formed. In that monolayers you have hydrogen atom, carbon atom, sulfur atom. Sulfur atom, sulfur is actually going to interact with the gold layer. So in 1985, after 1983-85, SAMs were developed. These SAMs are made up of alkanoic acids developed on aluminium hydroxide, that is aluminium oxide Al2. Then after that, other types of SAMs were developed. What kind of SAMs are available now? The other types are other sulfur head compounds, like disulfides and sulfides on metals, developed on metals. What kind of metals can be used here? Especially Au, that is gold, then silver, Ag, copper, Cu, and even platinum, iron, Fe, and nickel, Ni. And sometimes even semiconductors are also. Then trialkyl groups, trichloro groups, or trialkoxysilanes developed on silicon dioxide or silicon layers. Aluminium oxide or aluminium developed on silicon layers. Mica, glass is going to act as substrate. Fatty acids developed on metal oxides. Metal oxides like aluminium oxide, then silver oxide, like that. Then hydrocarbons developed on monolayer, developed on gold layer. Already I told you that functional groups are the head groups. They are going to interact and they will form monolayers. So what are all the functional groups used in SAMs? That is especially the functional groups used for SAMs based on thiol groups. That is thiol based SAMs. Here the functional groups structures are given and the name of those structures. So these groups are alkyl groups. They can be used as functional groups on thiol based SAMs, SAMs. And this is CF3, trifluoro or difluoro, methyl or methylene groups. CH2OH, CH2O, CH2 is hydroxyl group or ether group. COOH, COO minus carboxylic acid. CO2, CH3 is ester group. CONH2, CONH amide group. Chlorine and bromine, the chloro binding or bromo binding. CN is nitrile group. NH2, NH3 plus amine group. BOH2, borate group. And this is alkene structure group, alkyne group, diacetylene group, aryl group. These are all the functional groups. They can be used in thiol based self assembled monolayers as functional. And again, this is another type of functional group used: oligo, phenylene, ethylene group, or OPE. Or this is another one, is quinone group, which is used. And this is a monomer, n times repeated polymer, that is oligoethylene glycol, polyethylene glycol, PEG structure, that is used as functional group. Then this is a sulfone group, and this is epoxide. This is pyrene ring, pyrene group, and this is azobenzene group. All are used as functional groups in SAMs. And here you can see that the role of this N-alkane thiolate self-assembled monolayers developed on gold particles. So these type of SAMs, they are well ordered SAMs that can be formed from a variety of sulfur containing species. Sulfur containing species like thiols can be used, sulfides can be used, disulfides can be used. Then the interaction here is gold covalent bond. The covalent bond strength between gold, because it is developed on the gold. It is developed between the gold and thiolate. Energy is 44 kilocalories per mole. It is more than 10, very strong interaction. One of the highest kind of covalent bond strength between a non-metal and a metal. It forms rapidly, typically within seconds to within minutes. So this is a very strong SAMs. The gold surface used here, it is relatively chemically inert. It does not readily form a surface oxide because it will not interact. It will not form any surface oxide nor keep a strong hold of adventitiously adsorbed material. So these kind of SAMs therefore can easily be prepared in adverse conditions or ambient condition. Again, you see that these kind of SAMs, you see that at low surface coverage, these alkane thiolate molecules, they lie flat with their hydrocarbon acting as backbones, hydrocarbon backbones parallel to the gold surface. So in that way, the monolayer is formed. At higher surface coverages, in lower surface, hydrocarbon backbone will be formed. It will be parallel to the gold surface. At higher surface coverages, the molecules begin to stand up with the hydrocarbon tails tilting approximately 30 degree angle. So the tail region will be tilting 30 degree angle approximately from the surface normal and nominally in the all trans configuration so as to maximize van der Waals interactions. So because of that all trans configuration, maximum interaction happens through van der Waals forces. And here you can see that one N-alkane thiolate SAM developed on gold. This yellow one is gold layer. On that gold layer, N-alkane, this group, this white one is N-alkane thiolate SAM is developed. So on the surface of the gold layer, you see that they are all arranged as monolayers. The square the root is 3 into 3, and the angle is 30 degree. Then alkane thiolate lattice is formed, that is crystal-like lattice on gold. The alternating orientation of the alkane chains defines a 4 into 2 interaction. 4 into 2, here you see that four alkane groups, they are arranged in a super lattice structure. This is super lattice arrangement. That kind of monolayers are formed. And what kind of adsorbates, that is substrates, adsorbates and substrates used for developing self-assembled monolayers, like gold. See that in the previous case we have seen gold, which is acting as an adsorbate or substrate, and it is used to develop a self-assembled monolayer. Here in this table we are going to see what are all the adsorbates or substrates used for developing self-assembled monolayers. Surface adsorbate is metal. If it is metal adsorbate, then the substrate that can be used are gold, silver, platinum, palladium, copper, then Hg, mercury. And on these substrates you can use adsorbates like RSH group, RSS, sulfur dioxide, and RSR, RNH2, RNC, selenium, SCR, TE, then carboxylic group. Suppose silver is used, RCOH, RSH is used. For PT, RNC, RSH is used. For PD, RSH, thiol group is used. For copper also thiol group. For mercury also thiol group. If surface adsorbent is a semiconductor, then the substrate used is group 5 and group 3 semiconductors. Then INP group 3 and 5, cadmium, selenium 2 to 4, 6 group, zinc, selenium, and for all these substrates, the adsorbates is thiol groups. Then if you are using oxide surfaces, then the substrate used are aluminium oxide, titanium oxide, then barium oxides, then TLBA, the calcium copper oxide, then ITO, silicon dioxide, SiO2. Here the groups used are carboxylic groups, amine groups, thiol groups, then even silicon groups. So here we can see another type of self-assembled monolayers. They are called mixed type of SAMs, mixed SAMs. That is, by mixing two differently terminated thiols in the preparation solution. So you are taking different types of thiols and putting into a preparation solution. From that you are going to develop a self-assembled monolayers. They are called mixed SAMs. So the relative proportion of the two functionalities in this assembled SAM will then depend upon several parameters. What are all the parameters? The mixing ratio in the solution, the alkane chain length used there, then the solubilities of the thiols in the solvent used, then the properties of the chain terminating groups. Then the molecular gradients used in SAMs. Here you see that this picture A, B, C, and the last one is D. Here you see that gold is going to act as a substrate. On that monolayers are developed. So this is this structural illustration of the preparation of two component alkane thiolate gradients. This is first picture, the two different thiols. This is one, another one, this is gold, represented by X. Here this is X, first one, and O, this is second one, are injected into glass filters. Through glass filters it is injected. Then second one here, they diffuse slowly through the, they are diffusing through the polysaccharide gel and attached to the gold substrate, so that they bind on the surface of the gold substrate. Then third stage here, C, top view. It is showing the placement of the gold substrate between the filters. So that gold substrate is actually developing here. Then here, the last one, D, schematic illustration of a fully assembled gradient. So see that monolayers are formed, assembled gradient monolayers are formed, and this is the one monolayer, enlarged portion of one monolayer, where you see that gold is here and you see that thiol groups are developing monolayers like this. Then what are all the characteristics of self-assembled monolayers, that is self-assembled monolayers? Characterization of SAMs. How to characterize SAMs? What are all the studies or methods available to characterize these self-assembled monolayers? So characterization of SAMs: contact angle goniometry, that is CAG, C-A-G. This is a method used to characterize SAMs. So this CAG has been often used to examine the general hydrophilicity or hydrophobicity of the surface of SAMs. Another method used, study used, is X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy, XPS. So this XPS testify the bond types, the chemical bond types between the head group and the substrate. Then it will define the chemical species and oxidation states of constituent atoms in the SAM, and at the same time they will demonstrate that the film is of single monolayer thickness. Then FTIR study, that is Fourier Transform Infrared Spectroscopy study, FTIR. So this FTIR has long been used to measure the vibrational frequencies of bonds, that's chemical bonds within molecules. So here you can see that alkyl tile groups, they will vibrate at characteristic frequencies, a particular frequencies. That frequency region is between 2800 to 3000 per centimeter. That is the characteristic frequency region. So both the breadth of these peaks as well as the frequencies of the vibrations themselves yield a picture of the relative order and fraction of chain defects within the self-assembled monolayers. So this is a kind of study that gives you the arrangement of functional groups or what kind of atoms are available in that SAMS. By vibrational frequencies, we are getting the peak, from that you will identify the groups. Then electrochemistry method. Here you see that as electrons can be moved controllably through a SAM, electrochemistry can also be used here to reduce or to oxidize pendant groups at the solution. So the film interface that may be used for further reaction. Then scanning probe microscopes are, what kind of microscopes are used? STM scanning tunnel microscope, AFM, that is atomic force microscopy, LFM, again this is force mile, that is left force microscopy, where we are going to use all these three type of microscopes for scanning the structure, the monolayer structure. They are greatly assisted in the patterning of SAMs. What pattern is the layers are arranged, that you can view it through these microscopes. The patterning of SAMs by analyzing the spatial distribution of adsorbates across a surface. Then patterning of SAMs. So the selective removal of particular adsorbates can be done. Then the selective placement of adsorbates can be done. The selective reaction of adsorbents, you have to study that. Then their destruction with energetic beams. Then their deliberate removal with the scanning probe microscopes moving in a determined rastering pattern. Then the application of force or delivery of low energy beams. See that all the types of patterning is done here. Here see that micro compact printing. See that PDMS contact, and see that developed monolayers are developed. B, dip pen nanolithography. This is another method. AFM dipping, meniscus is there, and you are developing in the monolayer. This is another type of monolayer developing. C, energetic beams. Using energetic beams, you see that SAM is developed. SAM, here metal layer, and you see that atoms with electron beam, they are masking on the layer, and you will get the monolayer. Then D, here thermal processing. Here you see that in presence of solvent, you are heating it. Because of the heat energy, thermal processing, monolayers are formed. Then E, differing functionality. Depending on their functional nature or functional group, they will develop monolayers because of chemical interaction. Then F, electrochemical desorption. You see that monolayers are formed by electrochemical desorption because of charges present in the layers. Then G, STM induced desorption. Through STM tip, you are inducing desorption and you are developing monolayers. Then AFM assisted nanografting, that is looking into the atomic force microscope, this is the tip of that microscope, and you see that you are scanning it and you are going to add the layers one by one. So these are all different types of the methods, patterning methods used to develop self-assembled monolayers. Yes, SAMs. Then SAMs can also be used in nanotechnology and in biology also. In biology area and in nanotechnology for sensoring, in sensors, nanosensors it is used, SAMs are used. So micro contact printing and electrochemistry, two areas, micro contact and electrochemistry are two particular methods of patterning SAMs which have found exceptional utility in making SAMs that are selectively activated to study these biological events. So any type of biological events, you see that if you want to study that one, you can take this micro contact printing and electrochemistry method, and you can study that events. Then sensor, that is in nanosensors. In nanosensors, for sensing purpose, you are using SAMs, where they are developed on immobilized layers. That is immobilization of enzymes developed on SAMs. So using these immobilized enzymes, sensoring is done. Here you can see one example. The diagrammatic representation. This diagram shows the covalently attaching proteins. Proteins are attached on the surface of SAMs. It is done by using carbodiimide coupling, which couples amine groups to carboxylic acids. Here you can see this one. This is a peptide, and this is the group which is going to be attached. Interaction takes place, and this is that where amine groups interacts with carboxylic groups. This amine group interacts with carboxylic groups. In the reaction, N-ethyl N-dimethyl aminopropyl carbodiimide, that is EDC, which converts the carboxylic acid, this carboxylic acid, into a reactive intermediate. This is the reactive intermediate which is susceptible to attack by amines. The amines are there in enzyme. So these amines will attack these susceptible groups, and enzyme will be immobilized. This enzyme made immobilized on the surface of the SAMs. Now this enzyme immobilized attached SAMs are used in nanosensors. In this video session, we have seen about one of the area of nanobiotechnology, that is self-assembled monolayers. These layers are formed on a surface with the help of nanoparticles like silver or gold nanoparticles. Hope you have understood this. I'll be coming back to you in the other session. Until then, it is bye from KNS Biochemistry. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Namaskar.